there's a lot of truth to it, this generational perspective. Obviously, a lot of people know that Angela Nagel wrote a book essentially arguing that one of the reasons why the kind of new right has had so much success in attracting younger people is because that's where you now go to be culturally transgressive. You know, 25 years ago in the 80s or the 90s, it was the age of the moral majority and the Catholic Church, and it was like Sinead O'Connor being culturally transgressive by ripping up a picture of the Pope, and that was how you were cool and edgy, was rebelling against right-wing cultural institutions. And so if you were 20 or 22 and looking to, you know, kind of sow your oats and in that transgressive energy, you naturally went to the left. And obviously that went back to the 60s as well, with that whole revolution there. Now the people who promulgate rules for how adults can have sexual relationships, almost like they're the Vatican, are the people who are found on the left. And there's this kind of sexual libertarianism, this libertarianism around our private lives, increasingly found on the right, that also has this transgressive energy that I think has done this generational reversal.
One of the features of this, the new politics, is that it doesn't have the art, the music, the comedy that came out of, like, say, the 60s liberation movements. There's none of that. And I think this movement, as Glenn says, it's losing some young people because the codes of behavior are so strict. And that tendency to be the person who is constantly policing the speech of everybody else in the group, you know, again, that used to be the conservative in the room a long time ago, and that was why a lot of us became political liberals, right? If we remember Tipper Gore and the PMRC, right, or the bands of NWA.
7. The only permissible paint colors shall be black, white, or gray, despite the recent availability of certain alternatives.